flooding caused a huge mess across the metro, including one of our area's newest freeway projects. So this morning, CDOT is responding to how the Central 70 project got swamped.
After that, when I see that all water just came on top to the car, so I mean, like, say, what the hell, you know, like, what happening over here? So I don't have idea this day happened.
Yeah. Fortunately, he's smiling. Everyone is okay today, but certainly some scary moments on the highway. Things are much clearer now after the heavy downpours that we saw last night, which is great to see. There's still some flooding out there, though.
Unfortunately, yeah, some standing water in spots, some localized flooding, and boy, those winds yesterday as well. Up to 60 mile per hour wind gusts were recorded with those strongest storms right around dinner time. But this morning, all is clear and dry. We're at 68 degrees now, relative humidity dropping after a kind of humid start to the day, where we are still seeing some moistures over the southeastern corner of Colorado, down south to Trinidad. Some lingering light shower activity will taper off here in the next couple of hours, and we'll be under a mostly clear sky from the mountains to the northeastern plains for at least the first half of the day before clouds increase slightly. Today, our temperatures will be near normal. 79 by noon will top out in the upper 80s by 3 o'clock. We're expecting a high of 86 out of the airport, 87 down through Highlands Ranch into Parker as kids head back to class. There in Douglas County, expect a slight possibility for a gusty late day storm, but no risk of any severe weather. Otherwise, by 3:30, you can see just mostly cloudy skies, an isolated storm into our southern foothills and over the far eastern plains near Lyman. Risk of any severe weather will be low for today, mainly just some strong winds and pockets of light to moderate rainfall possible. Otherwise, northern Colorado is going to stay mostly dry and clear. We'll start off with more sunshine on Tuesday, and it is going to be a day where you definitely want some sunscreen. Colette, mostly sunny and a very high UV index. Protect your skin for today.
Good to know. Always bring that sunscreen along with you. We don't necessarily need it when we wake up for this shift, but I'm sure everyone else out there does. Unfortunately, we do have a couple of problem areas in and around the metro. Let's get you right into the heart of it right now, though. Crash at 25 southbound at University Boulevard. Take a look at our CDOT cameras. That backup really adding on a significant amount of drive time to anyone who is traveling along 25 southbound right there by University. So that's unfortunate. And then if you go just a little bit north to where we saw all of those problems with the flooding yesterday here along 70, that drive time looking a little bit more standard for this time this morning. But if you look at what Air Tracker captured just moments ago, cars driving still through flooded streets right there near York. So it's not on 70, but it's right there in that area that flooded. It does say it's passable with caution, but I'm always a fan of the turnaround, don't drown. Just in low cars, you never know. You can see some lower cars trying to get through it. Of course, those are just remnants of the worst of it. It was absolutely nightmarish out there last night. We're about to show you some truly shocking video from our reporter who's out there this morning.
Yeah, we've been showing you these images right here from the flooding along the Central 70 project last night. Some were able to plow through, but right next to it, an abandoned vehicle. So we want to bring in Denver 7's Christian Lopez to show us what we're seeing this morning, because there's still a lot of mud and debris left over.
Yeah, there is, and that mud even got me this morning as well. The good news is that no one was seriously hurt, and this morning things are looking a lot better and a lot drier. Traffic is moving along smoothly here along I-70, as you can see, but we did see a couple of abandoned vehicles on the highway that were covered in mud. Now, last night, we have that dramatic video to show you. Several drivers stuck in that water. You can see the traffic that was backed up. People were standing outside of their cars because there was nowhere for them to go. We talked to a man who was driving along I-70 when water suddenly went over his car on York Street. He couldn't even see in front of him because it was raining so hard. He ended up driving into the floodwaters, and he had to escape through his window.
The people over there helped. So, and he said, don't move. So, and I had my window down. So, and he tried to open that door, but the door, you know, they can't open. So I just got out from that window, you know.
It's insane. It's crazy.
Scary moments for people who witnessed that and knew this morning. CDOT says their systems were not ready for it.
Thank you, Christian. CDOT says the contractor on the Central 70 project, Kiewit, will help clean up the mud. A lot of people are asking, though, how something like this happened on this brand new construction project with a lot of state-of-the-art safety features. In our 6 a.m. hour over on Denver 7, I asked that question to CDOT for answers on the next steps.
We need to conduct a thorough investigation to see what exactly happened. Was there a system failure? Was there mud coming down from our construction site off of 46 South Avenue, as it hasn't been paved yet? I think the number one thing to remind motorists is that this is still an active construction zone. Our systems aren't 100% complete. Just as any construction project that's in an interim phase, you run a risk of potential flooding in a construction zone.
Stacia Sellers there told me that in an ideal situation, when the Central 70 project is done, pumping stations would suck the water down like straws and send them back out the South Platte River. But wild weather isn't stopping kids in Douglas County from returning to class today. Some kids have been dreading this day. Of course, it means the end of summer break. Others are very excited to be back and see their friends. Denver 7's Veronica Acosta caught up with students at Douglas County High School as they return to class.
Parent drop-offs and school bus drop-offs, they are a big part of that first day back to school. That's definitely the case here at Douglas County High School, and really all across the county as well. As students, they start heading back to school, and a big job for those bus drivers, as they are some of the few who get to get those students right back into their classrooms. Now, Douglas County School District, it is the largest in Colorado, with 89 schools all heading back today. There are roughly 64,000 students a part of the district. It's the largest employer in Douglas County with 8,500 employees. Now, while Douglas County doesn't have any new schools this year, they do have a brand new project that we want to talk to you about. The district bought the old wildlife experience in Parker last December. Right now it's being used for some meetings and some events as well. It's now called the DCSD Legacy Campus. When it opens to students next year, it'll be used for career, technical education, and work-based learning experiences. So not only an exciting year to look forward to next year, but again, a very exciting day today as all of these students head back into the classroom. We're in Castle Rock. I'm Veronica Acosta, number 7.
All right, so those are the high school ranks. Well, for some parents, today might be the first time you send your kids off to school. We asked a kindergarten teacher, Miss Halligas, at Vassar Elementary in Aurora, what kids should do to prepare for day one. Well, as a parent, you might want to teach your kids how to tie their shoes or get them Velcro to save time. Put labels on their clothes and materials because they tend to lose them. Find a neighbor, friend, or sibling they can sit with on the bus ahead of time. And this was interesting. Make sure they know how to unpack their lunch. They might not have had to do that before. And here's Mrs. Halligas' advice to our Danny New.
And things like knowing how to unpack their lunch, like Capri Suns are always a struggle for the first few weeks, or things like that. Those are always really helpful things for us as teachers.
Is it the idea of piercing the pouch? Like a harpoon, yeah. Almost.
Right. Yeah, a lot of them have never opened their own lunch.
But we would love to see your back to school photos and all those smiling faces in their backpacks and all their school supplies. You can share how your kids are getting ready on our Discover Colorado Through Your Photos Facebook page and tag us at the Denver Channel on Twitter as well. Still to come, keeping it real, we'll introduce you to a new social media app asking users to be more authentic in their posts.
Sort of stop what you're doing and just, you know, let everybody know what you're doing.